Hi there. Look at all the things that I have here on my desk today. Aren't there a lot of things here? You know, we've been talking about flowers, haven't we? We talked about the flower producing seed. Remember when we looked into one of the little cups of the flower, the dead flower, and looked at where the seeds first started? Well, today I have a whole lot of seeds here of a lot of different things. Some are flowers and some are vegetables that we grow in our gardens. And let's just take out some of these vegetables and put them here on the paper and see what the seeds look like, should we? All right. You know, on the front of each package of seed is a picture of what the flower or the vegetable will look like after it's full grown. And on the front of this one, do you know what these are? They're red, and we eat them. They're radishes. Let's just dump out some of these radish seeds right here and see what a radish seed looks like. Here they are right here on this corner, and they're just very, very tiny. Why, I can hardly pick one up between my fingers. Here they are right here. See how tiny they are? And I'm going to lay the package of seeds right there above them so that we know that these are the radish seeds. And then I have another package of seeds right here. Do you know what this is? This is something that we eat too. We eat it in salads. And it's green and it's lettuce. That's right. Let's dump out some of the lettuce seeds and see what they look like. Oh, look how tiny they are. They're very tiny, aren't they? If we put them all together, we can see them very well, but if they're apart, they're very tiny. And I'm going to lay the package down right here on top of them so that I'll know that these are the lettuce seeds. And these aren't anything we eat at all, because these are flowers. These are zinnias. And we can plant zinnias right now. So let's dump out some of these zinnia seeds right here and see what they look like. Oh, they're a little bigger, aren't they? They're the biggest ones that we've seen so far. And I'll put this right here so I know that these are the zinnia seeds. And then there are some more packages right down here. Do you know what these are? These are yellow beans, and they have much bigger seeds. Look, I'll show you some. See how big they are? They're great big ones, aren't they? And I'll just lay them right there. And then here is something else that we all like to eat, especially in the summer. We cook them and put lots of melted butter on them. Do you know what this is? It's an ear of corn, and an ear of corn has big seeds too. See? Here are the corn seeds, right here. And now we've looked at some different seeds, and probably if your mothers and fathers have put in their gardens already, maybe you've helped them plant these seeds, have you? Well, maybe some other ones then. But I thought it might be rather fun today to plant a garden right here and now. And perhaps you've helped your mother and father plant their garden, so you'll know some more things about them. But I have a great big indoor garden right here, and I'd like to tell you about it, because maybe you don't have a place in your yard, or maybe you don't have a place around wherever you live to make a garden. So I'd like to tell you how you can make one right at home. You can make one in a box. Did you know that? Whether it's an orange crate or a peach crate, or no matter what kind of a box it is, you can still make a garden. And I have a big wooden box right here that I'm going to plant a garden in, right here so that you can watch me. And in the bottom of this box, there are some holes. Do you see the holes in there? And the holes are in there so that after we put the dirt in, and when we water the garden, the water can run down through the dirt and come out a little bit through these holes so that we won't drown the roots of the little plants. But we wouldn't want water all over the floor or all over the table where we're keeping a little garden, would we? So I have some old pieces of brick and tile right here, and I can place them over the holes in the box. Now, the water can still run out. The dirt can't get out, though. That's what these little rocks are for, to keep the dirt in the box, but it lets the water run through just a little bit anyway. So I'm going to cover up all the holes just like this, and then over here I have a big bucket full of dirt, and I'm going to fill up the box with nice black dirt. Now, if you're making a garden outside, you'd have to spade it up and dig it up, wouldn't you? You know why you do that? That's to make the dirt nice and loose. Well, you can see as I'm pouring the dirt in this box here how nice and loose it is, can't you? Well, outside, we wouldn't have to pour the dirt into anything, so we'd need to take a spade or a shovel and just dig it up so it's nice and loose like this. Because if the ground is all packed down hard, the little seeds would have a hard time growing. Because, you know, it's a lot of work for them anyway to push up through all the dirt and come out above the ground. Oh, here we go, filling it up. And probably you won't want to bring a bucket of dirt inside the house like this, but you can take your box outside, maybe in a vacant lot or somewhere you could find a lot of nice dirt to dig up and put in the box. Now, I'm just using a glass jar to fill my little garden box with here, and it takes a little while, but if you used a bigger bucket or maybe a pan from the kitchen, it wouldn't take you so long to fill up the box. Now we have it almost full, but I want to put a lot of dirt in there so that you can see exactly what's going to happen when we do get all the dirt in there. So here we go. I think maybe one more or two more. I think we'll put two more jars full of dirt in, and then we can kind of smooth it off like this. You know, after you spade your garden outside, you have to rake over it, don't you, to break up the big dirt clogs and everything. There, maybe this is, well, we'll put one more in, just for an extra measure's worth. Right in there. And then I'm going to smooth it all out so that the dirt fits right nicely down into all the corners. You know, besides being fun planting seeds, it's kind of fun to play in the dirt, too, isn't it? But push it all out along the edges like that. And now it's all nice and flat on top, but you notice I didn't pat it down, did I? Just running my fingers very lightly over it like this. And then we're ready to plant the seeds. So the first thing we want to do is decide what seeds we want to plant first of all. Which ones that we looked at do you think we should plant? Well, this package right here has such a nice pretty red color on it. Maybe we should plant the radishes first, okay? And you know, on the back, there's a lot of printing back here. And it tells us just how to plant these seeds. And I'm going to read it to you and tell you what it says on the back here. It says to plant in rows that are about a foot apart. Now, of course, this means when we're planting out of doors, we want to have one row here and one row way over there. But since we're planting them inside, we can just make one row down here, and the next thing that we plant, we can put a little bit closer to it. But it says to plant them so that when you cover the seeds up, they're covered with 1/2 inch of dirt. Now, 1/2 inch is just about right there. So that's just how deep we want to make the row. So with my hand right here, I'm going to press down in the dirt and make a row. Can you see the row? And that's where the seeds are going to be, right in this row. And then I'm going to take the radish seeds, and I'm going to sprinkle them all down the row. See them? Oh, there's a lot of nice little radish seeds in there. Just like that. And then so that I'll remember where the row is, I'm going to stick a pencil right here at one end of the row, and I'm going to stick another one down here